Ciao ragazzi, mi chiamo Ivy e oggi voglio parlare un po' lentamente in inglese. Oggi l'argomento è cibo italiano in Scozia. Ho scelto questo argomento perché la cucina italiana è molto popolare qui, sia tra in casa che nei ristoranti. Secondo il mio fidanzato, la ragione è che la Scozia non ha molta cultura, ma non ne parliamo oggi. Comunque, come al solito, spero che questo video sia interessante o almeno utile e se avete qualche domanda fatemelo sapere. Ma per ora, andiamo! British food might not be the most sought after in the world, but we do love to eat. We consume vast amounts of Chinese food and Indian food, but most of all, we love Italian cuisine. And we see ingredients that come from Italy as being a sign of quality and taste. I don't know exactly how many Italian restaurants there are in my city, Dundee, but I do know that within a 10-minute walk, I can find 10 or 12. That's so many considering the fact that Dundee isn't even that large. While the prices of these places vary, Italian cuisine is generally considered a good quality choice for an evening out. And people who are into food in general will know a lot about Italian cuisine. Some people pride themselves in being able to pronounce the names of dishes correctly when they eat out at restaurants, but we don't always get it right. I'll talk about that later. Edinburgh is actually famous in the UK for having a huge amount of Italian restaurants. This is partially because of Italian families moving to the capital city and setting up businesses, and also because Edinburgh has a huge tourist industry and entertainments industry. People, for example, will go see a show in a theatre, but before that, go and have a pizza in the early evening. Again, the price and quality of these places varies a lot. Some of them are chains based on more Italian-American style cuisine, such as Frankie and Benny's. However, a lot of other restaurants in Edinburgh are owned by Italian families and run independently by the same people for years and even decades. You can usually tell if a place is authentic by having a look at the menu. Because British people, when they don't know what they're talking about, have a habit of doing things like spelling tagliatelle wrong or putting cream in carbonara. Naturally, Italian cuisine has affected not only the Scottish restaurant industry, but our takeaway industry as well. Here, we love to cover things in batter and deep fry them. We do this with scampi, haggis, sausages, and even chocolate bars. But we also do it with pizza. Yes, pizza. Deep fried pizza, also known as a pizza crunch or pizza crunchy, is available in fish and chip shops all across Scotland. I think a version of this, pizza fritta, exists in the south of Italy, but in Scotland it's a bit different. Here we only fry very cheap pizzas with thick bases, and the toppings are applied before frying, so when it's finished, the entire thing is encased in batter. As you can see, it doesn't look that appetizing, but people here love it. In fact, when I used to work in an expensive restaurant, one day all of the chefs had pizza crunchy for lunch and said that it was a classic. I'd much rather have a piece of fried fish, but each to their own. And yes, Scotland has a real love for ready-made pizzas from the supermarket as well. These range from frozen cheap pizzas with doughy bases to more expensive pizzas with fresh ingredients. And a lot of people make their own pizza at home too. When I was younger, my mom actually showed me how to make pizza dough so my friends and I could make our own over the weekend instead of ordering a takeaway. We always had salame picante on our homemade pizzas, which, as you probably know, we call pepperoni. Pepperoni is the most popular pizza topping not only in the UK, but in America as well. In Scotland, you'll also find a lot of stranger pizza ingredients. For example, in a lot of fish and chip shops and takeaways here, you'll find chicken tikka as an option for your pizza topping. This is probably because we love Indian food here, as I said earlier, and we love chicken tikka in particular. One topping that we do that actually does work fairly well is haggis on pizza. Knock it if you want, but don't knock it till you've tried it. I mentioned earlier that people from the UK have a habit of mispronouncing Italian dishes and ingredients. This included me, by the way, before I started studying Italian, so I'm not judging anyone. I just find it amazing that we can get it so wrong. For example, we love pasta here. It's incredibly popular, with many families eating it several times a week, and yet we can't seem to pronounce most of the pasta shapes correctly. In the UK, fusilli becomes fusli, tagliatelle becomes tagliatelli, and linguine becomes linguini. And I think most people just avoid saying conchiglia out loud because nobody knows how to. We can say spaghetti and macaroni, but that's because these words end with an E sound, whereas Brits tend to have more trouble with the A. I find this very interesting. Anyway, we eat a lot of pasta. That was my main point. Most of the time, it is a tomato-based sauce, and we usually have a large, heavy amount of sauce rather than a small amount. If the sauce is meat-based, we'll call that a bolognese rather than a ragu. And our ragus are strange in that it's usually a lot of sauce with a heavy content of tomato and red wine rather than white wine. Also, a lot of people here will eat it the American way with spaghetti rather than the more traditional choice of tagliatelle or some other flat pasta shape. Everyone makes the dish differently though. I remember my mother used to make it the American way all of my life until one day she bought a traditional Italian cooking book, and I was surprised at how much lighter and yet more flavorful the traditional recipe was. I guess the main thing is making something tasty though. And the same thing goes for lasagna. Everyone has their own interpretation on the dish. And I've had some pretty great British lasagnas. People here have the unfortunate habit, though, of topping a lasagna with cheddar before putting it in the oven. That I don't understand. We usually top pasta dishes with cracked black pepper and parmigiana, which here we call parmesan. Other hard cheeses like grana or pecorino are also available, but unfortunately, most people only know about parmesan. I personally like a huge amount of grana on my pasta, but any cheese will do. When it comes to Italian desserts, the one we eat most here is probably tiramisu. And to be honest, the tiramisus here are pretty good. The ice cream is not so good, however, there are a few fantastic gelaterias. For example, there is a well-known independently run Italian ice cream parlor near Dundee called Bisocci's. Versace's was created in the 1950s by a man called Marco and his brother, and the business became a popular tourist attraction, producing over 900 flavors, along with the classics, of course. The business is still around and thriving today because people here really appreciate businesses run by Italian families. Overall, while we do make some mistakes with regards to Italian cuisine, Scottish households wouldn't be the same without it. If we want to make a big baked dish to impress the family, we'll make a lasagna or a parmigiana. Or if we can't be bothered cooking, we'll order a pizza or get a ready meal from one of the local supermarket's Italian sections. Or if we want to impress somebody on a date, we'll take them to a fancy Italian restaurant. So the influence and appreciation of the culture is deeply rooted. I find this subject very interesting, so I might make a more in-depth video about it soon. If you'd be interested in that, please check out my channel and keep an eye out. But for now, have a lovely day. Baci baci, I'll see you soon. Bye bye!